Instagram Twitter or not just really depends on like what reference you're actually reading. And then I write that cheese. Oh, yeah. Okay, I'm almost done. And I also include Momoko. I'm sure you know. I believe this is my last slide. Momoko is a badass. She used to run a sweet pub in Roppongi before in Shangri-La, there's a, like, basically sort of apocalypse, and then there is martial law. So she used to run a really cool pub in Roppongi called Tropical Fish, and then before she transitioned, she was well-known judoka, and then in the anime, she gets a lot of jokes because she's obviously like attracted to men, and then it becomes some kind of butler jokes because she's often like perceived as like preying on dudes, which is real messed up. But like she's always flirting with the men that like end up interacting with her, and then she's just super flamboyant, super like out there. And then I always like to show this slide. My transsexual success. And that's like, this is literally one of her more tame outfits. Like, she's always just changing up her style, her wig, her outfit. I'm just like, she just slays it. Like, in every scene, like, I see her and her makeup is fresh. And it's like, you don't even realize, like, until, like, you see her in the background of, like, all this, like debris of like nuclear fallout that you're like, oh wait, this is supposed to be the apocalypse. Like, and where is she getting this? Is she just like raiding a Max store all of a sudden? Like,
huh?
Oh yeah. And then I'm usually like that I forget somebody. If you have a trans pair that you love that I didn't mention, I'm out of time, obviously. So I obviously can't have like a Q&A session, but feel free to meet up with me afterward. I don't have anywhere to be. And I did drive here, so I have all the time in the world. So feel free to talk to me after this. I'm more than happy to answer any questions. If you had like a concern, obviously I will remove that spoiler alert for next year. Thank you for letting me know. I'm sorry, I did not know it was a spoiler. I really do apologize.
You're still awesome.
Thank you.
Yay!
Thank you all for coming. These are my references. Like I said, Queer Japan, from the Pacific War to the Internet Age, from Mark McLellan. He talks more about gay history and trans history and lesbian history is kind of like a sidebar in the book. Honestly, it's like takes up maybe two or three chapters in total. Most of the book is about gay male history. And then I use transgirlmedia.wordpress.com. And then I also found a trap disposal unit, which I got more of the information from Momoko, as well as I believe about Brad. And then I also use bisexuality and transgenderism's intersections by others. By Jonathan Alexander and Karen Miskovich, which was more of the other background about Sunaku and other stuff that I didn't quite get from the original Queer Japan book. So that is my presentation. Thank you again for coming. And once again, like, enjoy the rest of your ASEAN. I know there's not much left, but I do appreciate you taking some time, especially so late, to come and hang out with me and experience my panel. Once again, I'm sorry it's 18 plus. If you had any like 17, 16 year old friends that weren't able to come in, I really do apologize. I'll try uploading this elsewhere, and thank you again. And like I said, I can't help that ASEAN has their own feelings about the subject of my panel and content of my panel not being appropriate for you.